One of my New Year's resolutions was to learn how to type faster, and I realized I was gonna need to break my bad habit of the technique that I created. The universally accepted way is the ASDF JKL semicolon way. It's way more accurate, and you don't have to move your fingers as much as the solution that I was doing. What I would do is I would literally try to find the I would use what I would use two pointer fingers and my thumb for the space, and I would literally look down and type, and I realized that wasn't gonna do it. I needed to learn the ASDF JKL semicolon technique, and I started about 2 months ago, and oh my god, the improvement is amazing. You really should start right now. The sooner you start, the better. So I am here to show you great techniques. You probably already know the ASDF JKL. You sort of probably understand the basics of it, but you don't really know tips. I'm here to give you tips. So if you want to learn how to type faster, stick around. One of the really important things when you're learning the ASDF technique, especially if you haven't done it before, especially if you did like what I did and you are trying to break that bad habit, because with the technique that I was using, I created it, I sort of looked down at the keyboard, but I also sort of looked at the monitor, but I was super inaccurate and I was always backspacing, and it just was not effective at all. It was really inefficient. And the universally accepted way is the ASDF technique. And that is, it can take a while. It took me a few weeks to really get the hang of it. The first couple days, you're in this weird stage. You're still trying to do your old technique, but you realize you're also you're in a transition phase. So you're sort of doing this, so it can be weird. But after, I would say, the 2 or 3 week mark, definitely it is worth it. So the website that I found that is excellent at this, and it makes it the workload, and I did it about 20 minutes a day, was called KeyBR.com. I'm going to show you in just a second just how effective it is. And there's also another thing that I will do afterward. As for how fast I type now, I'm about at the 2 month mark using this technique, and I've increased my words per minute by about 15 to 20, and you can get a lot faster. My accuracy before was about 75-80%, and now I'm getting 95-100% almost every single time, and it's just so much more effective, and if you stick to it, it's possibly gonna be one of the greatest things you have ever done. Okay guys, so once you get to this website, I am in incognito because it saves my progress through this, and I just want to show you how it looks like once you get actually on the website. So as you remember, you put, like I just showed you, ASDF, JKL, semicolon. Now for the O's, you just keep doing this. Now, I do this a lot, so I rarely mess up. But you just keep doing this. And what this does is you'll actually see this. So right here, it shows you the speed. Right here is the errors, and here is the score. You can pay attention to that if you want, or you don't have to if not. So what this actually does is, for these keys, it calibrates it. It calibrates it for all of them. And what it does is it emphasizes different letters depending on what you need work with. So, I can actually show you mine. I'll show you mine in just a second. So what this does, and I'll actually show you something. So that was 74 words per minute. That speed was 74 words per minute. So when I do this, and some days I'm off, actually, here's an example. So let's say I hit space, and I'm about to type in T, but for some reason I accidentally type in R, okay? What it's gonna do is it's not gonna let me actually type anything in until I hit T. Now what I do is, now it's red. So if I want, because remember, perfect practice makes perfect. You don't want to be practicing the wrong thing. So I just backspace and hit T again. And yes, it still counts as a mistake, as you'll just see. Hold on. Let me finish this. Now, that counted as two mistakes. There was two mistakes. So if I do this, let's do E, A, let me go back, A, L, L, oil, Nile, E, L, L, ill, E, lent, Lan, Olit, R-A-L-I-L-L-A-L-A. Okay, that was one error. so it still counts. And this score, you really don't have to pay attention to. But what you'll notice, especially after about around week two or three, like I was talking about earlier, after it starts to become second nature, you'll notice that your speeds are really going to start to pick up. When I first started this, I averaged about 25 to 30 words per minute, and that is just horrendous. Before, I was doing, remember, around 40 to 46, 47, and now, if I can actually go to 10fastfingers.com, this is an actual typing test, this is where you learn, and this is where you type out, or this is where I always learn, or I always test how fast I am. I do this every, okay, I can't really do this while I'm recording. I hate when people are watching me. Right, I'll start. So you just keep doing this, and then at the end, you just keep doing this, and you will notice a lot of results. You will notice results. It's not going to be this like, oh, this is sort of cool. It really does just work more. Keep doing this. So what I recommend is I recommend about 20 minutes a day of this, and I'll actually show you. Let me Alt F4 real quick. Okay. So this is the one that I always play. I don't know why it says 31 words. That's not true. Confidence level is sort of like how the closer to one, the better. That means like your mastery level. I really don't care about this. But one thing that you'll notice is the L's. I sort of have a little issue with the K's. That's what I'm on right now. So what it does is it does actually get harder. What's really weird, really awkward, is it will do a lot of P's, and when you get to the Q's and the P's, it gets really awkward. So Styways. I don't know why it says Y. I don't really have a problem with Y. So you just keep doing this for a while, and you will, I tell you, you will see results. If for some reason you heed my advice and actually start learning this. You know, if you're already doing this technique and you are slow, I would just give this a go every once in a while if you already are using the ASDF technique. You will speed up. You will speed up. Depending on how fast you're already typing. Some people, they really do have a limit. I don't honestly know how far or what my limit is going to be. So I just keep doing this. I made a mistake.
And that is KBR.com.
The only thing that I can do, which I want to make perfectly clear, if you're wondering, this video was not helpful at all. I can give you the tools to help you get better at typing. But the only thing that I need from you, actually don't give it to me, do it for yourself. Do it for yourself. This isn't just for typing, but for anything in general. You need to be dedicated. The only thing that you can do for yourself is dedication. I can only give you the tools. I've already given you the tools. Now I need you to be dedicated. That is the only way that you will ever, ever, ever become a better typer. If you like this video, remember to like or even possibly subscribe. But this has been Renenko, and I will see you guys in the next video.